Thomas the Tank Agent has worked his branch line for many years and knows it very well. You know just where to stop, Thomas, laughed his driver. You could almost manage it without me. Thomas had become conceited. He didn't realize that his driver was joking. Later, he boasted to the others. Driver says I don't need him now. Don't be daft, snorted Percy. I'd never go without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be frightened. Puh, boasted Thomas. I'm not scared. You'd never dare, said the other engines. I would then, boasted Thomas. You'll see. Next morning, the fireman came. Thomas drowsed comfortably in the shed as the warmth spread through his boiler. Percy and Toby were still asleep. Thomas opened his eyes and then he suddenly remembered. Silly stick in the muds, he chuckled. I'll show them. Driver hasn't come yet, so here goes. He cautiously tried one piston, then the other. They're moving, he whispered. I'll just go out, then I'll stop and whee! That'll make them jump. Very, very quietly, he headed past the door. Thomas thought that he was being clever, but really he was only moving because a careless cleaner had meddled with his controls. He soon found out his mistake. He tried to whee! But he couldn't. He tried to stop, but he couldn't. He just kept rolling along. The buffers will stop me, he thought hopefully. But the siding had no buffers. Thomas's wheels left the rails and crunched the tarmac. There was the station master's house. Horrors! Cried Thomas and shut his eyes. There was a crash. The house rocked. And broken glass tinkled. Plaster peppered the plates. Thomas had collected a bush on his travels. He peered anxiously into the room through its leaves. He couldn't speak. The station master was furious. The station master's wife picked up her plate. You miserable engine, she scolded. Just look what you've done to our breakfast. Now I shall have to cook some more. She banged the door. More plaster fell. This time it fell on Thomas. Thomas felt depressed. The plaster was tickly. He wanted to sneeze, but he didn't dare in case the house fell on him. Nobody came for a long time. Everyone was much too busy. At last, workmen propped up the house with strong poles and laid rails through the garden. Donald and Douglas arrived. Dinner, fetch yourself, Thomas. We'll soon have you back on the rails, they laughed. coughing hard, the twins managed to haul Thomas back to safety. Bits of fencing, the bush, and a broken window frame festooned Thomas's front, which was badly twisted. He looked very funny. The twins laughed and left him. Thomas was in disgrace. There was worse to come. "You are a very naughty engine," came a voice. "I know, sir," said Thomas. "I'm sorry, sir." Thomas's voice was muffled behind his bush. "You must go to the works and have your front end mended. It will be a long job," said the Fat Controller. "Yes, sir," faltered Thomas. "Meanwhile, a diesel rail car called Daisy will do your work."
"A diesel, sir? Daisy, sir?" Thomas spluttered.
"Yes, Thomas," said the Fat Controller. "Diesels always stay in their sheds till they are wanted. Diesels never gallivant off to breakfast in station masters' houses." Fat Controller turned on his heels and sternly walked away.